Not sure if you know this, but when we first met, I got so nervous I couldn't speak. In that very moment I found the one, and my life had found its missing piece. So as long as I live, I love you, will have and hold you. You look so beautiful in white, and from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. Love is timeless, my love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word.
So beautiful. The church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you together with your families and friends as today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this your joyful day. May he send you help from heaven to protect you, and may he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Anh chị em thân mến, chúng ta cùng với anh Đăng và chị Ti bước vào mùa thánh đường để cử hành nghi lễ này. Chúng ta vui mừng và sum họp trong nhà Chúa bên cạnh anh chị và gia đình. Đối với họ, đây là giờ phút đặc biệt. Vì vậy, chúng ta hãy lấy lòng yêu mến nghĩa bạn bè và lời cầu nguyện đượm tình huynh đệ và nâng đỡ họ. Hãy cùng họ lắng nghe lời Chúa nói với chúng ta hôm nay, rồi cùng với Hội Thánh và nhờ Chúa Giêsu Kitô khẩn khoản van nài Chúa Cha, xin Ngài lấy lòng nhân hậu đón nhận ban phúc lành. Và chúng ta cùng nhau với họ dâng lên Thiên Chúa lời cảm tạ, chúc tụng và ngợi khen.
So that in the union of marriage, they may be bound
come together in mutual affection, in lightness of mind, and in shared holiness.
Lạy Chúa, xin nhậm lời chúng con khẩn nguyện và đoái thương tuôn đổ ơn Chúa trên các tôi tớ Chúa đây là ăn đăng và chi thi, để khi được kết hợp với nhau trước bàn thờ Chúa, họ được bền vững trong tình thương yêu nhau. Chúng con cầu xin nhờ Đức Giêsu Kitô con Chúa là Thiên Chúa và là Chúa chúng con, hiệp nhất với Chúa Thánh Thần nên muôn thuở muôn đời.
Please be seated for the reading.
Thank you.
Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how those who have been served affections? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them with the river. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, although the servants who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and then when people have drunk freely, an inferior one. But you have kept the wine until now." Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs in Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We come here today to celebrate the wedding of Dan and me. But first of all, I want to welcome all of you, especially the parents, the family and friends of me, that you come here and you see something completely different from what you have been accustomed to inside church. So I want to ask you a question. Also to those families, friends and friends. That's your question. You come here today to celebrate the wedding. The question is, are you part of this wedding? Are you part of this wedding? If you are, remember to journey with them. To journey with them, because as they come together, new family together, their hands, they will have difficulties and doubts. They rely on your experience of life together that you've been through. Be that of just married last week, or be married for 30, 40, 50 years. They rely on your experience of married life, of husband and wife, of family life, to help them, journey with them. Because once you receive that invitation, and once you accept to be at that wedding, you are part of it. So, question. Next one. How many of you have watched the movie Mr. and Mrs. Smith? Raise your hand quickly, because I watched it several times. Okay, Mr. and Mrs. Smith. The word, now remember what's the last name Smith is very common in the US. It basically, it's kind of like saying it's any couple. Mr. and Mrs. Smith, played by Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt, at the time they are still dating each other. And sadly happened after they got married, they decided to divorce. But we're not talking about them. We're not talking about Angelina Jolie or Brad Pitt, okay? We talk about the movie, Mr. and Mrs. Smith. The idea is this. In the movie, two independent individuals decided to come together. Each of them have their own interests. Each of them have their own, how would you say, the whole baggage of monkeys on their back. So each individual, independent individual, separately they come together. What happens when they come together? They begin to find out that each of them were losing their freedom. Each of them were losing their interest because the other party is taking away that interest from them. If you remember carefully in this movie, they both have the same profession, right? Those who watch the movie, they both have the same profession, and the next thing you know, a conflict. It begins to create conflict in them. Remember, two individual, independent peoples come together to form one family. And the interests of the others begin to invade into the other person, of one to the others, and vice versa. And guess what? They fought each other. They fought each other. And halfway through the movie, they found out that each own interest began to try to eliminate the interest of the others. Remember? Two different companies, and company A saying, okay, you need to get rid of the person in company B, and company B saying, you need to get rid of the person A. So basically, because of the conflict of interest, because of the fear of the other person will destroy one's own interest, they begin to fight each other like this. Until they enter the big five sporting goods store. Remember that? They enter the department store, some kind of sporting goods store. They, of course, they fought each other and they realize, oops, we have the same interest. And their external forces from outside begin to come in and destroy us. So what did they do? Those who watch the movie, they worked together. They worked together. They worked together to unite their own interests together. Learning to forgo a little bit of one's next self and unite each other to work, and because of that, they survive. So my recommendation is that when you watch a movie, pay very careful attention to the first 5 minutes. Because if you don't pay careful attention to the first 5 minutes, you lose a lot of things. Because in that movie, Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie was inside an office of a family therapist. At the end of that, they're still inside that office and talking to each other, resolving conflicts, difficulties between them. So, to me, this movie basically said, if you come together, two individual and independent person comes together, you have to lose a little bit of yourself to accommodate the others.